Hi, Mike Snell. Sue Crawley here from beautiful British Columbia. Just sending you, Mary Claude and the girls, all my love, my thoughts and my prayers. You stay strong, my friend. Love you.
Hi, Michael. This is your amazing cousin, Teresa. Coming to you live from Vermont. So not far from actually one of your favorite places, Old Orchard Beach. I was going through pictures. And I was telling Tommy that I was probably making this a little more challenging than it needed to be, because I wanted to just kind of look at some of the things that remind me of you. In many ways, you and I, you know, along with all our brothers and sisters, we grew up together. And, you know, some of those early memories, and hopefully this will turn out all right, you know, these are some of the earliest memories I have of you. I don't know if you can see that really well. And of course, you know, the rest of the clan. And here's another one. There seems to be a theme about you on this one. But, you know, when I think back to those memories at Granny's house, which is now your house, those are some of the best times that I can remember, you know, in my childhood. And always was so cool to hang out with you and your brothers because, you know, I didn't have brothers. I had four younger sisters and, well, still do. But, you know, the fact that you guys were kind of the brothers that we never had, for me, that was really a cool thing, especially since you guys were so nice and fun to hang around with. And, you know, of course, I didn't do this, but my younger sisters, you know, as you started to grow, started to look at you like a tree and hang off of your limbs and climb up and down, and you were just always, you know, so accommodating. But, you know, so many cool memories of you and our families. And matter of fact, here's another memory. Old Orchard Beach, speaking of, you know, that's actually one of my favorite places. I know it's one of your favorite places as well. And probably because it brings back so many really cool memories of our families. And, you know, Granny and Uncle Jerry and our aunts and uncles and cousins all kind of running around the beach and then, you know, renting the houses and, you know, being able to kind of hang out and go back to the house we wanted to until Granny kicked us out and told us to go back to the beach. So this is a fond memory, just one example. Let's see if they can see that pretty well. But, you know, things like that are what I treasure. Those are the things that, you know, really speak to me. And then as we grew up, I mean, all of us kind of, you know, did our own thing, grew up in different countries, Canada versus the U.S. And so what ends, you know, up happening is that the times that we get together are less frequent, but it doesn't mean they're any less memorable. You know, as you know, we all had the opportunity to get together, you know, as a family. This is one of my favorites. So hopefully you can see everybody and it's not too shaky there. But, you know, it's these times too, even as adults, that for me, getting together was like, you know, we'd never been separated, you know, had, you know, that we'd seen each other last Tuesday. So, you know, those are what's meaningful for me, and I know they are for you too. I just wanted to tell you how much an important part you've always been in my life, even though we necessarily haven't been in the same place. And I love you madly. You know, you have amazing family, your wife, your children, your brothers, you know, mom, sister. It's just, you're supported by people who love you, and also cousins, myself included, who think the world of you and, you know, have just, can't express enough how much you've meant to me personally. So I love you, Michael. I will always know you as Michael. That will be what I always call you. And I love you, miss you, and you know, wish all the best, and I hope for healing for you and just an amazing recovery.
Hey, Mikey, it's your cousin Jake. Love you and miss you. Get better.
Hey, Mike. Just sending you really good wishes. Hello. Miss you around here. Missed you at Teacher Appreciation. And sending you lots of positive thoughts, okay? Big hugs to you and Matty Claude. Take good care.
Hey, Mike. It's Rob Kemp. Yes, I know the beard. Didn't recognize me. It's distracting. You're going to stare at it this whole video. I was thinking the other day, and I wanted to share this story for you. I don't remember if you realize how much of an impact, because I was just telling a friend of mine about it the other day. The first time I met you at the radio station, I was opping at CJD, and I went to get a cup of coffee in the kitchen at the automatic coffee dispenser, except I didn't have a coffee mug. I thought the machine sort of, you know, the cup dropped down and the coffee went in. No, you had to bring your own cup. So there I stood, exhausted, brand new op, and I watched coffee just pour all over the place with no mug. And so I was left with no coffee. And you went by and you went, oh, bummer! And then you walked away. And about 10 minutes later, you walked into CJD Master Control and you bought me a mug, a Mix 96 mug. And you said, nobody deserves to lose coffee like that. And welcome to the team. And I still have that mug at home too. And I've always remembered that story. And I tell it to people all the time. So I love you, pal. And I miss you. And thinking of you all the time.
Hi, Uncle Mikey. Just wanted to send our love from St. Catharines and wish we were there to give you a big hug.
We love you.
Hi, Mike. I am recording this video for you. And talking to you and thinking about you, I really went back in time in our early 20s and all the times we went out and all the times we had giggles and all the time you picked up Mary, and with picking up Mary came me and other girls, and you were always the man, living with all the girls and making sure that we went home safely. And how great was that? I also remember Marie-Claude puking out the window, and I remember when Marie-Claude drank too much and hit my two front teeth. And do you remember that, Mike, how much we laughed? Remember how you called Marie-Claude Pukey Mary? Because I remember very well, even if it's close to 25 years ago, but man, was that ever funny. It wasn't so funny that I had to spit out my front teeth, but then again, thinking about it, it was still good. I think it was in one of those moments where Marie-Claude had kind of drank too much, and basically her two arms baguettes were flying all over the place, landing on the beer that I was drinking that hit my tooth that then the next morning I spit out. And I just remember loads of fun, and I remember you always being there for all of the girls. I mean, your major girl always being Marie-Claude, and she always had a chauffeur, and she was always shielded and protected. And all of us little girl that tacked around in your big truck, room for everybody. And I remember lots of good stuff, Mike. And if I say your name, it comes with a big smile, and it comes with a big thank you, and it comes with a big I love you. So I hope this cracks a smile. I hope your brain can connect with mine with all of the stories and the fun that we had. And I squeeze you, I give you a big hug, and I will make you more videos. This is only the first, and I'm gonna think some more about the mischievous things we've done, and I'm gonna try to think of a story, one, two, three stories, that maybe Marie-Claude had not told you of things we've done together, and that will be tomorrow night, and I'll send you tomorrow night, because sometimes when you were not there, we did do girly stuff that was a bit mischievous. So now it is time to share those stories with you. Take care. Love you. Later. Bye.
Hello, sunshine. It's your other sunshine. Hi. Remember me? Oh,
hi, Mike.
Hey, I wasn't done yet. Oh. So, as I was saying, remember me? We had such great times on Fort Street, and now we're here on René Lévesque and Papineau, and I'm with this guy. Doesn't he look handsome? Tommy doesn't age at all. Look at him. And he's lost weight. And he's still in love. And he's just as sweet as ever.
I'm apparently the oldest one here, too.
Yeah, you're right. He is the oldest one here. I, on the other hand, won't even talk. No. All seriousness, we love you so much. And yes, and Tommy's like trying to steal my thunder all the time, coming in. No, come on in. Come on in. And we love you so much.
Love you, Mike.
We're sending you lots of love, lots of kisses, and we just want to see you get better. So we're going to go around the station right now, and we're going to show you around, because other people really love you too, and they want to say hi.
Wait till you see what's coming up.
Hey, Mike. It's Brian. Just sending you a quick video to say hi,
tell you that I'm thinking about you, sending you positive thoughts, and that I love you, buddy.
Mike. Mike Sinnell. I know. The hair. I'm on that same stuff that Trump uses. What is that, a Propecia? Is that what that is? You know what else happens when you take that? Known you a long time. Like, see that back there? It's difficult to see here. That's my Oldies 990 Employee of the Year Award. That's a few decades ago now. But that's how long I've known you. And I think about you all the time. And I understand you're not feeling so well right now. That is unfortunate. Please, my friend, get well soon. All right? We're all thinking about you. And lots of love coming your way. Okay? Seriously, lots of love coming your way.
Hey, Mike, it's Tim from Vancouver. Wanted to let you know that I'm thinking about you. And also to let you know what a big influence you were on me when I was at Mix 96. You know, you were always super fair, super professional, and most importantly, a really fun boss and a good person to work for. It's something I took away from Mix 96 and I use all the time in my own life now. So I'm thinking about you. I hope you're okay. Take care, my friend.
Hi, Mike. Danielle here in Bali. I want to tell you that I love you, and you have always been very dear to me. You believed in me in my 20s when I was a young woman and I really didn't know where I was going, what I was doing. I didn't have much confidence, but you believed in me. And I want to thank you for that. You gave me projects. You joked with me. You pushed me. You were always a key player to me. And for that, I wanted to thank you. And you're a very important person to me. I love you. And so here's a little piece of Bali, and it's nighttime. It's 6:30, so it's sunset time. This is just a little secret path near where I'm living. So, there's Juliet.
Just getting ready to go to dinner.
And there's Carly. And I drive a motorbike now, not a Hummer. Okay.
Bye.
Bye. I love you.
And who could forget my favorite buddy, the guy I went to high school with, Matthew Wood. Do you remember us? Yeah? What a team, right? He hired me. You hired him. We were like this great promo team. I wasn't making money. I was picking up speakers and serving hot dogs at movies in the park.
Wash your car, Miss Gargiulo, and your dry cleaning will be ready at 2. And I got the list of groceries that you wanted me to pick up. I'll have them delivered.
Okay, thanks. See? Some things just change.
Hey, Mike, it's Rob. Just sending you a note to say how much I love you. Hope you're hanging in there, buddy. We know you're sick. We love you lots.
Hey, Mike.
Hi, Mike.
Just calling to say hi, and we miss you, terribly so. We had to host a teacher appreciation on our own. What a nightmare, and Tara's jokes really suck.
They're not as good as yours, and our PG meetings are so boring without you guys here, and they're also, I think there's about 4 or 5 of us, so it would be, we really miss you.
Yeah, we were thinking of you all the time and remembering all the good times we had together and the fun bowling night we had for the graduation with you guys in your own little balls and shirts, you know, making us look like little schleppas. But anyways, take care. And
take care. We send lots of love.
Lots of love.
Bye.
I like or Mr. Swizzle's dicks hanging out of your pocket at Ziggy's. I wonder if you remember this. 18 years ago, trying to throw me into the pool. Take care and be good, my friend. I love you.
Big Mike, Roscoe here, sending you positive energy and hugs, but not too many of those, because I know, you know, when we try and hug it out, it makes you feel uncomfortable. So we don't want that going on. Drove by a Kojak's the other day and thought of you like I do every day, and had a good laugh, and want you to keep your chin up. Again, send positive energy your way, and look forward to a visit soon enough. Take care, bud.
Hey, Mike. Greetings from Toronto. Lise Fire here. I just wanted to say hi and let you know that I'm thinking of you and have been thinking of you lately a lot. And I wanted to send tons of hugs and kisses and love your way. And I've been thinking so much about the old Mix 96 days, like I wrote to you, all those good memories and good times. And I don't think you realize at the time how special a time it was with a special bunch of people, and you were a big part of that. You not only taught me everything I needed to know about radio promotions, but you always made it fun. We always had good laughs, and you gave me a very strong work ethic that has stayed with me my whole entire life. So I have you to thank for that. And I know that you and MC were talking about the first time I showed up to Movies in the Park with my white pants and long nails. I don't know what I was thinking, but I quickly learned not to dress like that, but how to work hard and have fun while doing it. And that's one thing we always did, and you were always keeping us laughing. And again, some of the best times of my life. And you know what? I was thinking of the day the first time I met you. I don't know if you remember this, but I was in Martin's office, and he had hired me just for the Bare Naked Ladies concert that coming weekend. And he told you to come in to meet me. And I was sitting on his chair, which seemed very low, and you're so tall, and you walked in and you were hovering over me. And I remember thinking, oh my God, I have to work for this guy. He is so intimidating. And I remember being nervous and wondering how it was gonna go. But I quickly learned, as intimidating as you are and can be, that you were a giant teddy bear, and you had a heart of gold, and you did a lot for me and gave me a lot and gave me a lot of opportunities that I'll never forget. And I think we had such a great relationship and we had so much fun. So I just wanted you to know that, and just know how special you have been in my life, you and MC. And you guys as a couple have been someone I've always admired as well. And with your beautiful family too. Yeah, so I just wanted you to know that, and just wanted you to know that I'm thinking of you, and I wanted to send tons of love. So love, 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 hugs and kisses. Okay, bye.
I know, some days you have bad ones, right? And all you need to hear is this.
Michael, so first I want to say thank you very much for knowing every single word to Don't You Want Me Baby and singing it, like all the time, all the time. Second, I want to say that you are bigger than life, and I love you, and I wish I could hug you. That's it.
Go. Hi, Mike. We miss you. The golf tournament is not going to be the same without you. We get asked all the time whether you're going to come and MC it, and we're thinking about you, and our thoughts are with you and your family at this time, and courage.
Hey Mike, it's Shelley. I'm thinking of you today, and I just wanted to send you a big hug and kiss, and just also wanted to let you know how much I cherished our time together at Mix 96. It was really a special time and just so much fun. I've got great memories of our time at the ski team and all the other fun things we did, and really just all the laughter and all the good times. And that was mainly because of you and your awesome sense of humor. So I hope today's a good day for you. Let it be known I'm thinking of you, and lots of other people are too. Lots of love, Mike, and lots of love to you, Mary Claude, and your daughters.
Hi, Mike. It's Jamie.
Jean-Luc.
Luke.
Liam.
Yes, and Liam. And we are sending lots of good vibes and lots of love.
Tell them. It's Christmas Eve.
It's Christmas Eve. In Farts Day in our house. Oh, okay. Lots of good vibes and lots of love to Uncle Pete's little brother.
Mm. I love you. I love you too.
Bye.
Hi, Mike. We just wanted to say we're thinking of you and sending our love. Take care.
Mike, how are you? It's Jeff Vidler. It's been a long time. I think back to the years that I was in Montreal, and those were a magical time. There was a lot of wonderful people, and you were one of them. And I'm really sorry to hear that you're not feeling so good these days. Just want to let you know, there's lots of folks, including people who haven't seen you in a long time, who are out there cheering for you. Get well, my friend.
You're on.
Hey, Mike. Just waiting for my Starbucks gift cards and my Black Sabbath tickets and, you know, all the other goodies you used to give me once a year. So, you know, what's up with that? I haven't gotten them in a little while and I'm getting a little antsy. So, you know, anytime now.
Hey, big guy, it's me. I am dropping you a line from Melbourne. Just checking in to see how things are going. And to let you know that I'm thinking of you and the girls and MC, and I hope you got the case of Bull's Head that I sent to you. I wish I was there to drink it with you. Love you loads, and I will touch base soon. And remember, we'll always have Old Orchard. And I still don't know what the fuck I was doing there with you. Love you loads, bye.
Hi Mike, it's the St. Marie / Trifoletti. We want to tell you that we're thinking of you, and we want to say hello.
Hi, Mike.
We admire your courage and your strength. We're sending you our love to you and your lovely family. Hugs and kisses.
Hi, Mike. It's Anna Marie again. I'm back. This time I want to thank you for all your wonderful help with the Parents Guild. I have wonderful memories, fond memories to keep with me forever. Thank you for being there, for never saying no, and being a wonderful partner to work with. The thing I remember most though is those mangoes. So thank you for everything. Love you dearly.
Hello, Jerry. I paused so you could say your line. Wanted to take a few moments just to say that you're thought of very, very often by a lot of people who love you very much. And we're thinking of you, thinking of your family, and wish you all the best.
Hi, Mike. Sundown in the Paris of the Prairies, a.k.a. Winnipeg. Yeah, it's the snow just melted. Heard you weren't feeling well, and sending you lots of love from Winnipeg. It's your old pal, Matt Kundal. Think of you often when I go to buy hockey equipment for the kids and our times at Shome. Want you to get better, feel good, and know you're loved.
Hi, Uncle Monster. I just wanted to tell you how much I love you, and I wanted to thank you for all of the lessons that you've taught me in my life, how to tell a fantastic poop story, and most importantly, the importance of family and keeping them close. I thank you, and I love you more than anything in the world.
Poop stories have always been good. You've been good at those. I figured we'd bring you surf, sand, and sun, so we're at the beach at Point Pleasant Park in Halifax, because I know you love that kind of thing. We love you, brother. You take care of yourself. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Hey, Mike.
Mary Claude.
Val.
And Sabrina.
We love you guys.
So much.
We're thinking about you.
And we really miss you.
You've done so much for us. Please let us know if there's anything we can do for you.
Anything at all.
Bye.
We love you.
Bye.
Hi, Mike. Hello from Ottawa. Well, you know, we're into the playoffs, so here's the deal. If the Habs get past the Rangers, now that's a big if, I'm thinking that it's going to be the Senators over the Canadiens in six games in the Eastern Conference Final. So if you want to put a site bet on that messenger meat, let's put a few bucks on it. And, you know, Ottawa's the town. Look, come on, they have a better jersey. Always thinking of you, Mary Claude and the girls. Take care.
Hey, Mike. I was wanting to reach out. We haven't seen each other in a while. And as you can see, I have donned the lovely mini ears. My daughter thinks I look completely ridiculous. But the reason for that is because they were working on some projects recently. So we got an opportunity to look through some pictures of their trip. So I wanted to say thank you very much. We kept saying how amazing and how helpful you were in making this trip probably one of the most memorable. So you'll always be a part of the most memorable moments of my children's life. And it was a lot of fun. And I have someone here very special who has a message for you.
Thank you, Mike, for a memorable vacation.
So there you go. So we just wanted to say thank you, and we love you.
You're on.
Hi, Mike. Feels like yesterday that you proposed to me. Still waiting for the real ring, though, and I'm really anxious to get our wedding plans together. So, yeah, give me a call when you can, and we'll talk. Thanks.
Mike, we love you.
Love you. Natasha wanted a threesome, so here we are. Hi. Matthew.
Allô, toute la famille, c'est Nathalie, Félix et Jules.
On voulait vous dire allô.
Oui, Jules aussi. Bon, tu vois, Julie, t'as un petit mot aussi, Mike. On voulait vous envoyer un petit mot pour vous dire qu'on pensait très fort à vous.
On vous envoie plein de bonnes ondes.
Plein d'amour, oui. Plein de lumière.
Ouais.
On sait que ce que vous traversez, c'est pas facile, mais malgré tout ça, il y a des super beaux moments.
Rempli de bonheur.
Oui, dans tout ça, pareil. Alors, ouais. On voulait vous dire qu'on vous aime, Mike, on t'aime.
Oui, on
puis
t'aime.
Puis, on va toujours être là pour oui. Marie-Claude, Valérie et Sabrina, toujours. Alors, on vous aime fort. Mouah. Mouah. À bientôt.
So I get wind that there's going to be a video done for this guy in Montreal, and I thought to myself in those immortal words of Danny DeVito,
I want in.
Radio, you got to do the drop. You know, you got to do the drop. Hey, Mike, how are you, man? I wanted to be a part of this because, you know, my years in Montreal were some of the best years of my entire life. They were fun times, and you were a huge part of it. You know, you probably don't realize that. I don't think anybody realizes how much impact they can make on someone else. I mean, I'm always surprised when somebody will come up and say something to me that I, you know, like, wow, I didn't know that. And, you know, and I want to tell you that, of the impact that you made. You know, when I got to Montreal, I didn't know anybody. And, you know, I'm at a new station. And you know, in the beginning, I was probably fairly aloof because I didn't know how many people I'm gonna have to fire. You know, you go into one of those situations, and you know, and after, you know, after that was sort of quickly figured out, I was sort of shocked and amazed at how fast everybody became friends with me. You know, I didn't view anybody as working for me there. I thought we were all just buddies trying to do some cool shit. And that's what we were doing, and you know, and you were a huge part of that. I can vividly remember us walking down the street for lunch day after day after day after day. They were the best. I missed that immediately when I got to Calgary. I was like, oh man, I don't have all the gang to go out and you know and have fun with at lunch. And you were a huge part of that. I can remember us going to. It was down the street, sort of by the Forum, but not quite to the old Forum, and it was on the left-hand side, and I want to say it was Bob's Subs or Mike's Subs? I think it was Mike's Subs, and you know, when you gave me the entire history of Mike's Subs, and it was really early on, I was like maybe week three or something that when I was there, and, you know, it told me all about, you know, the history of the place, and because I just thought it was a little one-off place, and not realizing, you know, it, like many other things of the city that, you know, that I would not know unless I was a local. And, you know, when you told me about that and you told me about the city
And and it's similar type stuff would happen at that. There was another place kind of down past the forum, a chicken joint. We used to go in there and, you know, crowd in and just shoot the shit and have fun. And you helped me really quickly become a Montrealer. I felt like a Montrealer. I didn't feel like an outsider in any way. And I tell people all the time, guy must have told this shit 100 times to people. Sometimes we'll go into a Chinese restaurant, I start telling them about the peanut butter dumplings that we used to get at that other place down, and how, you know, we really would fight over the plate at the edge just so you could kind of lick the sauce off the plate, and they're looking at me like I'm from Mars. It's just like, well, yeah, but that's kind of the camaraderie that we all had. Then it was, you know, just a, it was like a bunch of high school kids just having fun, you know, doing stupid shit and doing cool shit. And Mimesos, oh my God, that was awesome too. Give me the whole history. I didn't even know who, not following hockey, I had no clue even who Mimeso was. I was like, it's like a mess tent, or is it a messy place, or what's Mimeso? I don't know. But, you know, and you would explain the type of sandwich and how they did it, and I don't know, they were just awesome times. And also, you were a big part of making the station a success. Although, when I look back, that success is such a sort of a, it's kind of a minor thing. You know, it's the relationships and it's the people that I remember more than ratings and stuff like that. Like, I can't ever remember, I always thought you were always in a good mood, it seemed like. I can only remember you maybe blowing your top, like, maybe, I don't know, twice, if that. And they were kind of large blows. You kind of like, whoa, okay, don't get in his way. Don't get anywhere around him. Let's let him cool down. But other than that, you were like always in a good mood. And then it was always cool to see you and always smiling and happy and stuff. And so it made it a joy to come to work and have you kind of, you know, for all that time right outside my door. It was without a doubt just good times. They were good times for me. Hopefully they were good times for everybody, and hopefully, you know, they were good times for you, that when you think back and remember, it's like you were part of something. To go back to the ratings and all that sort of stuff, you're part of something that most people would never ever in their entire lifetime in radio ever be a part of, something like that, because that was a magical place during that time, and it was magical for everything we did. I mean, it was almost surreal, how successful everything turned out, and you were a huge part of that, and I thank you for being my buddy and being my friend, welcoming me in, and for, you know, helping build that radio station. It was a really cool time. I miss that. You know, I miss that at times. You know, and I miss all you guys. And I wish I had more chance to actually get up there more. But once you move away, pretty much you're gone. That's kind of, at least that's always the way my life worked. But anyway, I just really want to be a part of this, Mike, and and to say hello. And, and give you a glimmer of what you added to my life. The one thing I always remember about you, and I'll kind of end this because I know that there's other ones. You were the first person I ever heard ever really say this. And you used to say this all the time. So I will end this on that note. You used to always kind of, you'd be, cranking out the door or something, and you'd kind of like look up and go, "All the best. All the best," and then you disappear. So I will say that right now to you, Mike, and absolutely from the bottom of my heart, all the best. Oh my God! One last thing I gotta tell you. This is gonna sound strange. Every single time that I am driving somewhere, like it happens a lot going to Florida because I just see more trucks. every time that I'm driving somewhere, I will turn to my wife Vivian or who's ever next to me and start talking about the pickup trucks that have the four wheels on the back. You know, remember you had one? And because I always, if I see a pickup truck with the four wheels in the back, whatever they're called, I don't know, I always, always think of you and the look on your face when you came into the station, like you didn't know whether to shit or go blind when you came in, because it had, you know, it got stolen out in front of the apartment. And the look of terror on your face was amazing. I always thought that that was cool. So whenever I see one of those trucks with the four wheels, I think of you. So you have probably been in my thoughts, you know, one way or the other, probably at least once every other month for the last, whatever this has been, 20 years. I don't know. Since 1996, 2006. Yeah, 21 years. Yeah. It's been pretty awesome. Anyway, just wanted to add that on. All the best. Take care. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. That was the other one. Bye-bye.
Hey, Mike. Babbins. Hi. This is our thank you, goodbye compilation thingy, which is weird, but... you know, happy to be able to do it and tell you how much we all love you and we'll miss you, even though you'll kind of always be around and little things always make me think of you. For some reason, every time I see a hockey stick, I'm not sure what that means. Anywho, I'm trying to say thanks. So thanks for that time you got me those KISS tickets. One of the last time I saw the original four members. So yeah, you created that. And I'm trying to think what I could offer you. And I looked around the shop. And I've got some matzah and some pot. So yeah, you say the word and it's on the way. Okay, love you. Bye.
Cuckoo Mike. Remember me? I'm the one you used to kick butt when we were playing tuck and you enjoyed every minute of it. Just to say I'm thinking of you lots. Love you.
Hey, Uncle Mikey, it's your cousin Joey from Texas. I love you and stay strong.
Hi, Mike, it's Nat and my little friend Artie. Yeah, it's my little buddy Artie. And just checking in to say that you are awesome and very sincerely, I think about you every single day. And when I do, I send out tons of love, like a Care Bear, to the universe, to you and MC and the kids. And I just wanted to let you know that. So... sending you tons of love from our little place here in NDG. Right, Artie? Look right in the camera there. Say hi to Mike. Right there. There you go. Yeah, it doesn't understand the concept too well. But we love you, and we're thinking of you. Mwah. Right, Arthur? Right.
Hey, Mikey. It's the rest of the Texas clan, Trish and Bob, and Rowdy. Who's not? We love you and miss you. Stay strong, man.
Love you, Mikey. Virtual bro hug.
Hey, Mike. Sean Ryan here. You never had to drive shotgun with me on that first date for my daughter. By the way, thanks for the offer. And thanks for the memories and the laughs. I really appreciate it.
Oh, yeah. Great memories, Mike. I can't even look at a Mars bar without thinking about you and Matthew Wood. Never mind. Let me start. Wait, Mike, wait. Let me start again. I can't even look at a Mars bar without thinking about you and Matthew Wood rubbing it on your teeth and saying that Daddy thought you were the best kisser. Nor can I look at a caravan on the highway without thinking of your Rico Suave story. So thank you for all the great memories and thank you for all the great laughs.
We love you, Big Mike.
Love you, Mike.
Take six.
You're up.
Hi, Mike. I just want to say a big hello. My thoughts and prayers are with you and your family. I've seen Val a couple of times. She looks great. I did call you a couple of times. But I know, you know, I didn't get back to you, but when I see Valerie, she gives me, She gives me news about you and Marie-Claude, and I just want to tell you my thoughts and prayers are with you, and I miss you. Take care.
So after our meeting, we go into here. Oh, Andrew Carter, say hello to Mike Sinnell.
Mike, how are you?
Yeah.
It's nice to see you, Mike.
Did you always dress like this on the morning show?
No, I just dressed up for Mike today.
Oh, okay, good. I'm glad you did that for him.
Mike,
who are you on the phone with?
We're thinking about you, man.
Who are you on the phone with?
Hey, you know what? Let's give Mike a good luck makeout session,
okay.
You and me.
No problem. Go. Okay, enough. Jeez, you don't know when to stop.
Mike! Emmy,
we love you, Mike. Kisses, can you blow kisses? Can you blow kisses? Go blow kisses to Emmy and Mommy. Stop.
Hi, Mike, we miss you, we love you.
So now we're gonna walk through Shom, of course. We're gonna go see our very good friend, Terry DeMonte. I know you always have to knock and see if the light is off. Hi, guys.
Yeah.
Good morning. Good morning.
What's happening?
You know, we're just saying a nice hello to our good friend, Mike Sinnell. Hey, you look great, Terry.
I'm sleepy. I'm sleepy.
You've never looked better.
Hi, Michael.
Hi.
Hi, Michael.
Hey, Mike.
Hello, Michael.
Hi, Mike.
All right. So,
How's
the lighting? Beautiful. You look great.
Okay.
Okay. And let's see.
Regular glasses or reading glasses?
Let me see. Oh, I like the reading glasses,
actually.
These are
from the dollar store.
Oh, you're so trendy.
Thinking of
bye
you,
bye.
Michael. Bye.
All right, Mike. Listen, we're all here. You're definitely here with us. Right here, in the hearts. We needed you for the Montreal Canadiens win. Would you stop farting? Hold on, Mike. We'll be right back for take number two.
1 minute.
All right. Okay, so we're back for take number two. Stuco's done his farting. And Mike, what we want to say is that you are definitely always in our hearts. And... we miss you. We really love the fact that you've been with us for so long, so many years, and you'll always be with us in our hearts.
Yep.
Stuco, anything?
We love you, Mike.
Okay, it's take three. We're going to come back.
We're going to come back for take number three. All right, we're back. All right, so Stuco had something for you.
Like Simon said, right here in the hearts.
Easy, then.
The hearts. We love you, man.
Didn't you take down the giant?
I have the belt.
He's got the belt.
I still have the belt.
All right. The belt.
We love you, Mike.
That's all we got. Not him. Anything else?
We're going to miss you, Mike. We love you, buddy.
All right, buddy.
You're the best.
Peace.
Well, hello, Mr. Sinnell. It's Victor Newman. I hope that you get this message. I recorded it and asked that idiot Tim Klassen to send it to you. Now, as you know, he's not the sharpest knife in the drawer, so it's a bit of a crapshoot as to whether you'll get to hear this. Someone told me that you're not well. I told them I've known you're not well since 1995, but they said that you're really not well. And some people say that positive thoughts can sometimes help people improve. So here are some positive thoughts. I'm positive the Leafs won't make it past the first round of the playoffs. In fact, I've asked Miguel at the ranch to whip up some 50th anniversary cakes so we can send them to all the golf courses in Toronto. I just wanted you to know that both me and Timbo are thinking about you and hoping you'll get better. Actually, I've been hoping you'll get better since 1995. And by the way, Mikey, if you're feeling a little down and feel that the odds are against you, just remember these important words. Tim Klassen had a girlfriend. Now, I know normally I would yell out, now don't call again, but it's 3 a.m. here, and I'm pretty sure my neighbor is Osama bin Laden's cousin, and I don't want to piss him off. Take care, Mr. Senile, and get well.
Hi, Mikey. How are you? I'm glad to talk to you. I wish you were here. I'd like to come and see you, but we're too far away, and Mikey says you got to be careful that I don't hurt myself. I love you very much. Wish you were here. Wish you were talking to me right now, standing in front of me. Anyway, I love you, and don't worry. I'll take care of your two grandchildren. I'm their grandma. Love you. Bye.
Love you, Mikey.
Love you, Mikey.
I love you, Michael. Always remember that. I love you, and I do, and I always did. And it's not goodbye. We'll meet again, my brother. You take care. I love you.
Take care, Mikey.
I love you, Mikey.
Love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.